Hi there, Lindsay here, the Frugal Crafter. I just wanted to hop in really quick and show you some of the things I just got from Michael's, and there was a couple things that I'd ordered that finally arrived. I'm not even sure if I'm gonna publish this video or not, but I thought I would film it because I'm really anxious to get using these materials. And so sometimes people like to see unboxings. I do, I like to see them. I just kind of feel a little bad because I've been living a little high on the hog lately, stocking up for things for next year, and I don't want this to feel like a contest. I'm excited, and I want to share these things because I'm so excited that I found them, and you know, you guys might be looking for them too, and I thought it might be kind of fun for you. So the new Jane Davenport line came out at Michael's, and I don't have a Michael's nearby me. It's about an hour and a half away, so I got together with a few girlfriends, and we were all kind of, I was like sharing pictures of them and sharing, you know, like, oh my gosh, look at this, it's so cool. And so when I saw that they had watercolors and these fun markers and stuff, I really was hankering for them, and a lot of people were emailing me and asking me if I'd review them because they were interested in whether or not the supplies were going to be good or not. And so I decided to give Michael's a call and see if they even had the stuff in stock, which they did. And I had looked online, everything was out of stock online, but the woman at Michael's said if I tell her the SKU numbers of what I wanted, she would see if they were in stock and hold them for me if for 24 hours. If I wanted her to. So I was so thankful for that because she did. And then a 30% off coupon came, your entire order 30% off. So everything in here I got for 30% off, except for the markers, which I got for 40% off because they let me use two coupons. So I just thought it was a great opportunity to be able to try these different things, to review them for you, use them in some projects because so many of you have asked me about them. So this was something I didn't really know about and I wasn't intending on getting, but I just thought they were really sweet. And actually, you know, I think that I'm supposed to open it like this, like a deli paper box or something, but this is what these are, because I did open the end and peeked at them before I decided whether I was going to buy them or not. They're like napkins. If you've ever done, I have a video on transferring a napkin, like using napkins and card making, but they're napkins, and you would iron, usually what you do, well, you can use Mod Podge or matte medium or whatever to adhere them to your project, but something else you can do, which is really fun, is you take plastic wrap and you put cardstock down, you put plastic wrap on top and you lay that down and then you iron over it. It makes like a fabric paper, which is so lovely for card making. I'm just going to adjust my light a little bit here, so hopefully you can see it a little better. But there's a lot of really pretty designs, and I'm hoping I can get them back in the box because I really want to show you. I could probably make something like this, you know, I probably could just save my paper towels after I'm done painting, quite frankly. They're never this pretty though. So I just thought that would be really fun because the napkins that I find for like paper crafting aren't really that pretty. I mean, they're pretty, whenever I see pretty napkins, I'll grab them, but who needs, you know, 50 napkins of the same pattern? Nobody. So I'm also planning on sharing this with some of the girlfriends I went down to Michael's with so that we all have a little bit of the collection. Some of my friends got things that I didn't get, and I'll talk about that in a little bit because, you know, we're all really good about sharing our supplies, and if somebody gets something, a lot of times we'll all buy different stuff because we know we can all kind of like share, you know, my supplies, your supplies. Like if you have that stamp set, then I do too, because I'll just borrow yours. So we kind of make a lot. I'll put this back in later, but we do that a lot. I'm lucky to have crafty friends nearby. So I want to show you the thing I was most excited about first. These two things. This was what I was planning on doing. I was like, okay, what am I going to get? If I'm driving all the way to Augusta, then I'll probably get both of these. I'll use a 40% off coupon on one and I'll just buy the other one full price. But since it was 40% off one item and 30% off your entire regular price order, I thought that, you know, I'm going to splurge since I drove all the way. And I got these watercolor palettes. And many of my viewers asked me to review these. So obviously I don't have a review yet because I just got them. I'm very anxious to try them, but I don't like to unwrap a watercolor palette, paint a couple swatches, and give my opinion on it. I don't think that's right. I think I should use it a little bit, inform an educated opinion before I tell you guys whether it's worth it or not. I don't think it's right to rush through it because somebody's company's reputation is on the line, and my reputation is on the line, and your pocketbook's on the line, right? So it's not right for me to just rush through it. So it's got a beautiful little card, a little swatch card. I probably will swatch it on watercolor paper just because I'll see how it behaves a little bit better. But you got the little pan holder. This pan holder has enough space in the middle to put another row of pans. I imagine they're very similar to the Prima ones. I know like the Prima pan, the pan stays out nice and straight like that instead of dipping. And these are also made in Korea, as are the Prima watercolors, and they're about the same price. These retail for $29.99 in Michaels. Pardon me, and I paid $21, I think, with my discount. So not a bad price for 12 watercolors if they're decent, and about the same price as what you'd pay for Prima, except none of the big box stores, at least around me, carry Prima media products. They'll carry like some papers, but I never see the stamps and the products like that. So this was the bright palette. So you got nice bright fresh tones there, and this is the neutrals. But I saw on one video Jane call them warm primaries and cool primaries, and I love the thought of that, because I like to work for my split primary, although this looks like you have a pretty good range of colors in here for mixing. So if you have to pick one, I'd probably say go for that, unless you're very unless you're kind of not confident about mixing skin tones, because it looks like this is kind of designed for doing your skin tones. So that might be a little bit more useful if you have a little bit of trouble in that area. I feel like this was probably a tremendous risk for a company to come out with a big media line like this, because these are more expensive to produce than like papers and stickers and stuff. So it's kind of a cool thing. And plus the colors, I mean, I think that's what really drove the want monster in me for this, was just like the colors of the palettes. They're affordable. I hope they're wonderful, because I love to find $30 isn't cheap, cheaper versions of art supplies for people. And this was the thing I was also very excited about, and I kind of was thinking at first, no, I'm not going to get these, but I had quite a few people ask me to review these, so I decided, well, there really is an interest out there, so it's worth me making a video about, because, you know, it's kind of my business, making videos, so that's kind of worth me reviewing it if I have so many people that are interested. Now, I've had paint-filled pens before, ink-filled pens. I've had the Elmer's Paintastics, which are wonderful, and they were very inexpensive. You used to be able to get them at Sam's Club. And I've also had the Benfang watercolor pens, which were a better quality but way more expensive than these. So this would be kind of in the middle. I'm curious to see the quality of these pens, and I'm going to compare them to the other ones that I have. These seem to be like water brushes, and you know, even if you don't like the ink, when you run them out, you don't throw it away. You just use them as a water brush. Even the company says to do that, so it's even on the packaging. I love that. I love it that it's not a disposable item. You can refill it with your own liquid watercolor or your own reinkers in water, or you can use it as a water brush. I think that's awesome that the company encourages that instead of just saying, oh no, buy more. And when you use those up, you better buy more. A lot of companies do that, and that just bothers me. Same thing with these watercolors. If you use them up, you can always refill them with tube paints, or you can order individual paints. They don't have them, but sometimes when media products from a craft company take off, they will offer open stock. I know Crafter's Companion did that with their markers. It usually takes a while though, because they have to sell, I think, so many units before it becomes financially viable for them to do your refills. You know, they have to make sure they're going to actually sell the refills before investing in refills only. So that's something, that's why a lot of craft companies don't do that, because kind of the trend goes by and people are on to the next thing and they're not buying refills for their product. So a lot of times that's why you won't find like an individual marker by, you know, a company that doesn't make markers. So that's why. This was something else that, you know, probably wouldn't have ended up in my cart if it wasn't for the 30% off. But I really thought these were sweet. And there's 7 rolls of tape and 2 of these of washi tape. Let's open them up and see. So these ended up costing me $7. Regular price is $10 on these. Regular price on these is $39.99, and I got 40% off, so I think I paid like $24. Would that have been $22 or $24? I can't math on the fly. So we got these washi tapes here. They're all kind of face parts, and I don't feel like I need help drawing faces, but I like that I've got this option here. So I thought those were really, I gotta hold them down here in the light. I thought they were really cute. And this has, you probably see it better in the box. You've got little, these little people, like the Alice in Wonderland people that she draws, some watercolor, some girl faces, some more watercolor, and then you've got all these like fashion girls there, which is kind of cool. And then there is, there's this one, which is a bunch of, there's mermaids and more fashion girls and some words. Just very fun, inspirational, carefree, love it. So I did grab those because I thought those would be really fun accents on art journal pages and cards and stuff like that. So I was looking for more things that I could do with cards and maybe some art journaling because I tend to make cards more than anything or do some scrapbooking. I didn't get any of the planner things because I have a planner. My planner's actually right here. I have a planner that's extremely functional. It's not the most, you know, fancy decorative thing in the world, but it works for me. So I'm not going to go down another planner road. And I also got the paint over pens, which I think might, they say they're an acrylic pen. I think they might very much be like one of the chalk markers, that those opaque inks. But these were quite affordable. I thought they were $7.99 regular price, and then I got 30% off. But I liked that that you have, I think there's two whites, different tips maybe, and then you've got these three colors. They'll go on top of your pen. If you go over your paint, I'm sorry, the go over your paint. If you go over acrylic paint with like a Copic marker, you have the chance of lifting up that paint and it clogging your marker nib. So you kind of don't want to put your, you know, alcohol markers at the end. Your water-based markers are going to bead up or they're not going to dry completely. And then if you touch over that, you're going to get it on your hands. So I thought this was a great idea. And it was actually cheaper than a lot of the other paint pens in the store. So I thought that that was a really fantastic value. And I look forward to trying that because I only had like one acrylic, a couple acrylic paint pens, but they're all used up. They're long gone, so I don't feel too bad restocking those. Something that came out a couple years, like maybe last year at CHA or maybe 2 years ago, and I couldn't find it anywhere, was this bracelet jig. So we're done the Jane Davenport stuff. We're moving on. So with a 30% off, I decided I, and since I, you know, if I have to drive a long way and I've got a coupon, it totally helps me justify these extra things. But this is a bracelet jig, and it's for artistic wire, which I happen to have quite a bit of. And I've been in a very slump, a very big jewelry slump lately. I haven't made any jewelry in a long time. And I thought that this might brick me out of it because this was a product I've wanted to try. It's for, you put these pegs around, I don't want to take it out and lose anything, but you put the pegs in this cylinder, and then you wrap your wire around it, and then you remove the pegs and you slide it off and you have a bangle bracelet. And I just thought it would be really fun to use with some of my artistic wire. And hopefully it's as cool as I thought it was when I first saw it debut like a year ago or so. And I've been looking for it and haven't been able to find it. But our local big box craft stores, we don't have a Michaels. It doesn't seem like they have a really awesome jewelry department. And it seems like a lot of the beads they have are all second. So I do find that you have better luck with jewelry stuff at Michaels. I wish we had one close by, but we don't. I can't really complain. I mean, I have a couple craft stores nearby, but we don't have Michaels. I did get some toggle clasps that were on clearance for $1.49 each. I prefer to use toggles even for necklaces and bracelets just because I find them easier to personally take on and put off, put on and take off. And then I got some cord ends because I have a lot of satin cord. I like to use it, and I usually do an adjustable knot closure with them, but it's kind of, I don't know, clunky. So I think this will give me a much more sophisticated look, and I could actually, you can use these on any types of cords. So I mostly have satin cord, but I do have some hemp that might be kind of interesting, especially in the smaller little ones in this assortment. I haven't used these before, so I'm looking forward to trying them and seeing if I like them. And they weren't very much. They were, you know, regular price $2.99, so I probably paid $2 a package with my discount with a coupon. And then I thought this was very cute. It would go with some of the other stamps that I have. There's a flamingo pineapple and palm leaf and a hibiscus flower. They're clear stamps, clear layering stamps from Hampton Arts. And these were $7. So I thought, wow, that's a great deal. Now, they're not the best quality of stamps. I mean, if I open them up and smell them, I can tell they're not, like, they're not, they're really good ones. They have, like, no smell. So they're, you know, they're the cheapies. But what do you expect for $7? I can scuff them with an emery board and stamp them. And I was waiting for my friends to cash out, and I'm standing at the end of the cash register, and I said, well, I'm just going to peek around here while I'm waiting. And then I had to go back through the cash register because I found these 79-cent gems. I'm going on a trip in a couple of weeks, and I got some really cute scrapbooking paper, which you probably saw in my last haul, that had a map on it. And I thought this would be really cute to stamp on the map and, you know, maybe write some travel stuff. And then the mason jar stamp and dies you saw from my last haul. These are all little fruits I thought would be really cute to stamp inside my mason jar. So 79 cents for this and for this. These were little kits. I had previously ordered this and they finally came in. New sets, new colors in the memento dewdrops. And I like to have these, especially for my office upstairs, because I can have all these options of colors out and not take up my entire workspace. So these are new colors. As far as I know, maybe they're not. This is a snow cone set. They might have been out, but I've never seen them before. So I've got 12 new colors here. Is that 12? Yeah, 12 new colors here. And I just buy the re-inkers and I refill them because they're raised pads. You can ink any size stamp with them, but they're a lot cheaper than buying the full-size pads and they take up less space. I only have the full-size pads in Rich Cocoa and Tuxedo Black because those are the ones I use the most. I'd be forever rinking the little dewdrops for those. So other than that, I find that these are really great for being able to have a bunch of colors out and not covering your desk. And then I didn't have these colors either, Paris Dusk and Desert Sand, so I grabbed those. And I haven't got the re-inkers for these yet, but they're pretty easy to find, so I'm not worried. I can order those as they start to go dry. And oh, the only other thing I have to show you, oh my word, isn't that bad? I've shown you plenty. I've shown you plenty these last 2 weeks. I'm kind of ashamed of myself. But I also ordered this, because what happened was I needed some storage. This is the irony, folks. I needed some storage. So I was looking at the cute IKEA cart that everybody has, but they're not selling mint anymore. Then I saw on Michael's they had the mint cart, which made me realize, oh, I think there's some new Jane Davenport things coming on. So I checked that out, and that wasn't on stock. So then I had to go to Michael's and find those. But before I did that, I placed an order on Joann's for a storage cart, which, of course, it was 50% off, so it was a fantastic deal. But it didn't come with free shipping. So instead of paying the $5 shipping, I decided I needed to order another $30 worth of things so that I could get the free shipping. This is insanity. I am insane. I really should have my head examined. But anyway, so because was too cheap to pay $5 in shipping, I bought ink pads and this paper, which they were all on sale, of course. But this is all 50% off, so I can't really complain. But I love these nautical papers. It's kind of hard to find, really. There's a lot of like nautical designs that are like navy and white or red and white or red or just like Americana colors, which I love. But I always feel like they're way more, you can only use them like in July, or they just feel so patriotic, which I love the patriotic Americana, but I also love just like kind of nautical and tropical and that sort of motif as well. So I just snagged this. I love how there's like some gloss on some of these papers. And you might remember the seashell stamps that Stampin' sent me. I'm gonna use those with this. And I actually will probably use some of those watercolors with it too. I'm planning this, I've kind of got this cooking in my head right now that I wanna work on this weekend. So I don't know if I'm gonna show this video to you guys. Honestly, I have to admit, I feel like my name should be, I should take back the title of Frugal Crafter and just say the No Self-Control Crafter or something. But then again, on the other hand, people like to see the hauls and they enjoy them and they get a lot of views. So obviously more people like them than hate them. So I don't know. I guess it's kind of like a confession too. It's like probably like, you know, going into the little priest room there where you tell your priest, I'm not Catholic, when you confess, you know, maybe it's just like confessional. It's like, oh man, it's been 1 week since my last haul, you know. It's like I'm confessing, oh my gosh. Or maybe it's a little bit like, don't feel bad if you've, you know, splurged, because it happens to the best of us. But also you can see what's kind of out there and decide what's right for you. I like this. I like paper that I can cut apart and use as embellishments. I thought these were kind of stickers or something, because they almost look like that, but I'll probably cut them out and use them as embellishments because they're so stinking cute and they have that lovely texture, lovely shine to them. So I'm glad I got all this stuff. To tell you the truth, I don't regret any of it. Oh my gosh. I'm confessing and saying I don't regret anything. Oh my word. put me under interrogation. I'll sing like a bird. So basically that's that. I just wanted to share this with you so you could see some of the new Jane Davenport stuff. I didn't buy the Jane Davenport face stamps. They were really cute. They were very affordable. The regular price was like $6. But my friends Tracy and Kathy got them and they said I could borrow them if I wanted to. So if you guys do want tutorials with those, they said they'd lend them to me. So just let me know. I do just intend on sketching my own little faces, my own little people, if I want to do any Jane inspired stuff. But and I do have a couple things. You know what I'm going to show you really quick? We have some time here. We have a couple seconds. So I was just doodling around faces before. I was like trying to talk myself out of out of, I don't know if I'm going to show you this right side up or upside down, but I was going to talk myself out of going, and so I drew some, like, Jane-inspired faces and stuff, just because, well, those were my other drawings, but because I was so excited for this line, it was just inspiring me to create, and that's what products, I feel like they should do. They should be, they should help you, they should want you, make you want to create and not hinder you from creating, if that makes any sense, but that's all for my haul. I let me know what you want to see first, and the next video will be some of these in action. Thanks so much for watching. Until next time, happy crafting.